Hello everyone. Previous class we have discussed this one principle of insurance, that is six principle we have discussed in detail. In today's class we will move further to regulation of insurance. Okay, for each and everything, for companies or corporation, there is one management, no, which control, such as for bank we have which control bank, who control bank means RBI. Okay, RBI control bank. And for stock market and all, we have SEBI. Like that, for each and everything, we have one management. For this one also, for general insurance also, we have few management. Okay, that because insurance is very, very important. So that management have to be there, otherwise fraud will happen. Because of that one, we have two main statute which control insurance companies, such as one will be Insurance Act of 1938. Under this act, government tried to control general insurance company. I mean, apart from that one, Insurance Act 1938, we also have General Insurance Business Act 1972. Okay, then Insurance Regulatory Authority, okay, IRA also is there. But also this one is, first one is Insurance Act 1938 is one, like I have said, two main statutes is there that control general insurance. One is Insurance Act 1938. Another is very important, okay, that is Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority, that is 1999. Under this act also, government tried to control insurance. Discuss in today's session, we will only focus on this Insurance Act 1938. In future, maybe we will move further to another act and another organization we will discuss in future class, but today's we will discuss one, that is Insurance Act 1938. This act was passed, okay, before independence only it is passed, like it is 1938, and was brought into force from 1st July 1939. Okay, this passed in 1938 and it is came into force from 1st July 1939. This act is applies to GIC, means General Insurance Corporation. This act was amended in the year 1950 because government want, okay, after independence it they want to change regulation. So in 1950 it changed, 1968, 1988, and then last one is 1999. Certain government will specify limitation and restriction under which general insurance have to work. Based on that one, it look after, which who look after means this Insurance Act 1938 is just look after what rules and regulation formed by general central government, that they have to take care, whether companies are adopting that one or not, okay, whether they are following rules and regulation or not, that they will see this act 1938. Then power under section, who provides central government power, means this section 35 of General Insurance Business Act, Nationalization Act. Under this act, central government have power to provide restriction and limit. First one, registration. Okay, mainly if any act is there, okay, that govern or control registration, that control management or organization, means it have a power of registration. Okay, maximum, okay, if bank have to start, they have to take registration from RBI. Like that, if insurance company, if you want to start insurance company, then you have to took permission from whom? You have to took permission under Insurance Act 1938. Under that one, you have to register your company. Then only your company is in eligible. Then only your company is eligible to start business. This act is comes under Section 370. Under that one, you have to take permission. Okay, yeah, every insurer, that is insurance company, is required to obtain certificate of registration from control of insurance, under which act means Insurance Act 1938, they have to take by making payment of, by paying fees, okay, registration fees they have to pay and they have to register. Registration couldn't be renewed, okay, it have to be renewed, annually it have to be renewed. Okay, so it is not that only you have to take one time and you have to run, it's not like that, you have to, annually you have to renew your registration, then only your company in legally based in India. Okay, if you want to start your insurance company in India, then you have to register under this Act 1930. Yes, under Section 3 and 70. Under Section 3 and 70, you have to register under this Act. Okay, this is very important. Then moving forward to next, that is next provision under this Act, that accounts and audit. That this Act tell you to, this Act have a power to account and audit your transaction. Okay, this according to this Act and according to that one, like I have said, no, this provides central government, that is under Section 35, it provides central government to control and restrict insurance company like that. Because of this Act, central government can account and audit general insurance. That is, insurer is required to maintain separate account of receipt in receipt and payment in each class of insurance. That is from fire insurance, marine, and miscellaneous. And it tell you to prepare separately. Okay, it not tell you to merge everything. Okay, suppose one insurance company is providing all type of it cover all type of insurance policies. Under that situation, you don't have to prepare only one insurance account. Okay, for one company, it's not like that. You have to prepare separately based on your type. Okay, suppose if how much fire insurance you are providing, that is how much receipt you have collected and how much payment you have made, you know, from fire insurance policy. What about marine? What about miscellaneous? Means health will come, this motor vehicle will come, everything. Okay, for separate insurance policy, you have to prepare separate accounts. And audit, whenever insurance, this Act will think, okay, this company have to be audit. It is, this company is not in position to pay claim to customer. In that situation, it tell you to audit. Okay, it have a power to audit your company. Then next one is investment. Okay, coming to investment. Okay, this Act tell you according how insurance company have to think and how they have to plan their investment. Okay, investment of insurance companies are usually made in approval mode under provision of the Act. Guidelines and limitation are issued by central government from time to time that they will guide whom insurance company, central government will guide. And limitation means they will set limitation. Okay, suppose if you want to invest somewhere, okay, suppose you want to invest in one company, means up to this percent you can invest. Suppose you have 1 crore of amount. Okay, suppose insurance company don't have 1 crore, suppose 100 crore of investment they have. Okay, amount they have, surplus amount, and they want to invest that one. Okay, and they want to invest in some companies. Central government will provide restriction and they will guide. Okay, suppose if you want to invest in one company, you don't have to invest. Moving to next one. Oh yeah, coming to next one. I didn't tell this one. This accounts and audit comes under Section 28. Okay, Section 28, they have to maintain this accounts and audit. Okay, insurance company have to keep a record of all this transaction, that is accounts they have to do, and then audit also have to, they have to do, and they have to submit the same report to whom? Central government, as this Insurance Act 1938, that organization, they have to submit that report, that is accounts and audit of their company or corporation, they have to submit to whom? Regulator, they have to send. That is under Section 28. Under Section 28, they have to prepare accounts and they have to audit their accounts. Then they have to submit to a regulator of the company. Now moving forward to next one. Limitation of management expenses. Section 40. Okay, Section 40, this Act, according to the Act, prescribe the maximum limit of expenses of management, including commission that may be incurred by an insurer. The percentages are prescribed in relation to the total gross direct business return by insurer, prohibition of rebate. This Act prohibit any person from offering any rebate of commission or a rebate of premium to any person to take insurance. Any person found guilty would be punished with a fine up to 500 rupees. A fine is less because insurance, suppose motor insurance companies, insurance this policy will come up to 2000 or 3000 if it will come. Okay, so they are charging based on this insurance policy commission. How much commission you have to pay to your agent? How much premium you have to charge from whom? Your insured person. to take insurance, they are offering what rebate and commission. Okay, if you took this one, insure person, if you offer anything, and if you force them, that person, to take insurance from your company only, under that situation, if you found guilty, then you have to pay 500 rupees. Okay, for one policy. For one policy, you have to pay 500. You also have a power of investigation. When this this regulator thinks that this corporation is doing for fraud activity, in under that situation, it tell you, it guide you to investigate. That is, central government may at any time direct controller or any other person by order to investigate the affairs of any insurer or and report to the central government. If central government think this company is providing or this insurance company is not doing is not following our order and is doing fraud activities, under that situation, central government have a power of investigation. It tell it order whom it direct controller or regulator or any other person by order that their person have to investigate the affairs, that is transaction or affairs of any insurer, that is any insurance company, they can investigate and same report what they have investigated and what they have found from that investigation, that report they have to submit to central government. That this powers power also have with central government have this power, and they have obtained from which section 35, like we have discussed in the earlier slide, that is under section 35 they have a power to provide guidelines as well as restriction as well as limitation to general insurance company. Then last one is other provision. Also this other provision after deals with the licensing of agent. Suppose if anyone want to license, if any person want to take license, they have to take under which one? Under section 44. Okay, under section 42-44. Okay, well, under section 40 is what? Under section 40 is limitation of management expenses. Under section 44 is licensing of, if you want to do any research or something, you have to take permission from whom? Regulator. Under this act, you have to take any permission. And advance payment of premium. Okay, if you want to collect advance payment of premium, under that time also this act will come. Apart from that, you also have which this tariff. These are all the provision which comes under this Insurance Act 1938. Next, that is insurance, General Insurance Business Nationalization Act 1972, that we will discuss in next class or future classes. Hope you have understood. If you have any doubt, you can ask me.